The bougainvillea, some irises in the background among the flowers, if you see them in the distance. There's the first clematis flower there, followed soon, inshallah, by another 105. There's a small fight there between the boys. More irises of different kinds, the bamboo. And the fight. I was thinking to change the subject of my notes today and just show you a mako fight. And so you bet on it. Okay, sending the bets in the red corner, red guy in the... What's the other corner? Well, look, there's a blue guy in the blue corner, but are they red and blue or was it? I don't know about fights. This is not truly about fight. It's a Miguel attempt at the joke, and I let them because they're not fighting roosters or anything. They're basically friends most of the time, and this is their idea of fun. Sometimes they just try to assert domination. Sometimes they're both male, and who's top dog does likes to provoke, no? Returning, I'm sorry. Snow Falling on Cedars. A very interesting adaptation based on the book, which is listed on some by some critics. If I'm not mistaken, I found this, the book, and I've read it. I have a note on Goodreads about it. The book you find on the Friendswood list. There's a modern library list, as serious, I mean, everybody has a list. I have my own, obviously, you have your own favorites. But then, as compiled by scholars, not amateurs like myself, there's the modern library, there's the Time magazine list, old time 100. Now, it's not old time 100 books, old time 100 movies, because the books they refer to on the Time list are just from the last century, and not, they don't include the likes of Gilgamesh, Pride and Prejudice, Shakespeare, and other classics coming from centuries back. And there's a Guardian, I mean, it's on the Guardian side, but it was a list compiled by the Norwegian Book Club, which has the 100 best books of all time this time. And then they try to have them all together to score points and have a list which is basically about the other main important ones. And that's Friends. And here they have Snow Falling on Cedars, if I'm not wrong. And the film is, like the book, very good. Max von Sydow is there, a man that I like. Ethan Hawke, I was going to say Ethan Frome, because recently I had a note on the other important Ethan, more important than the actor, I venture to say, Ethan Frome, Edith Wharton. Max von Sydow is rather old here, and he has a joke as the lawyer in the film. You're not showing your age. You're acting a bit adolescent. The idea is behind this accusation. You're not acting your age, counselor. Well, if I would be, I would be dead, Your Honor. So a fisherman dies, and very soon a Japanese man is incriminated. And this is a story, a crime tale. Drama, a crime story, a mystery also, because we have to see who really done it, if anybody did. And it's about racism. It's included is the story of the Japanese who have been Japanese citizens, mind you, who have been deported in a measure which is sending us to the present with a wall, a big, big, beautiful, beautiful wall that Mexico will pay for it. Mexico will pay for it. Of that narcissistic elective in the White House. Narcissistic individual. And it's a complex story. Yes, the Japanese family had a reason, because when there's a suspicious death, they look for clues. If they suspect murder, they try and see what the motive would be, who has an interest in seeing it, are there money involved, and is it payback, revenge? And indeed, it's in the story, which is complex, worth seeing. There's a court drama, there's what happens behind, there's a historical context of the Japanese sent away in the war, Americans actually, of Japanese descent, which was very bad. Well, it was the war, but still, we can look back and feel it was awful. We can do that. And there was a land transaction, an advance money were paid down, but then the woman decides not to. Not to honor the deal, which, as she points out in the courtroom, was legal because she was covered by the conditions set there, and it was more of an arrangement, a gentleman's agreement, if you will. And then indeed it's pointed out by the accused when he visits her that, well, yeah, legally, but what about morally? This is the thing to do. And so it seemed that he might have had a reason, but did he do it? Well, it's for you to watch this good film and see.